Thank you for tuning into Cornerstone Abundant Life Church YouTube Ministry with Apostle Terry G. Simmons Sr. Please like, share, and subscribe to spread these powerful messages from God.
Enough to go the right way. He said, come on, son. You've been foolish long enough. Come here. Sit down. Let me guide you. What a wonder. Any man of this robe and come out of heaven for a sinner like me. What a wonder. And all of us still looking for something else. You get high, you got to buy some more. You get drunk, you got to drink some more. You smoke, you still got to buy some more. You buy food, you got to buy some more. I got Jesus free and ain't had to buy purchase or nothing else. All I had to do is just keep loving him. I ain't had to purchase nothing else. I ain't had to bring the preacher no money. What a wonder. The preacher's lying, tell you you got to buy your way to heaven. God ain't never said that. I love him. I don't care if don't nobody never come him, because the truth is him. We the best thing going in Pensacola, maybe in the United States. Because everybody else got some loophole. They got some tricks. But God said, tricks is for kids. Serve me. God got a word today for the house. And all y'all ain't really studying God, this might not be for y'all. And I don't have no hard feeling for saying that. Because if you ain't serving Jesus, you ain't got the best thing. And if you got anything that ain't serving Jesus, that ain't the best thing neither. We might as well be real. He's good, y'all. He's good. Oh, Lord. Ain't nothing like him, y'all. Y'all might have just been singing that. Y'all might have just been singing, he's a wonder. He took a rat like me and made me somebody. Care what nobody else think about me. I'm precious in his eyesight. And I'm just like a homely man. I ain't got no money neither. But I got his word. And when I got his word, I got him. I ain't even searching no more. 1 John, the first chapter. Begin at the first verse. And I continue on the 8th. But y'all know something? My God. All y'all waiting on going next door to eat? You better eat now. You might die before you get over there. And I got some chicken, potato salad, some collard green. I got everything you need right now. This the best buffet you can get right here. The B-I-B-L-E, the Bible, the Word of God. It's the best buffet. And the cook was Jesus. Now, y'all don't like broccoli? You can eat this broccoli. All y'all don't like rutabaga? Y'all can eat this. This spiritual. And all y'all like sweets, you can eat this. This ain't gonna run your sugar diabetes up. God got an insulin in it that won't let your blood go down. I'm happy today. I don't know what they're gonna be like, y'all. I'm happy. We don't make the devil mad in Pensacola. Every church is mad with us because of the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me God. The truth is making people mad because everybody got gimmick and don't nobody want to live by the word. But God said his word is truth. Sanctify him with the word. Can't sanctify you with nothing else. You can dip in all the water you want. If you ain't sanctified by the word, you ain't clean. I better go on and read this. 1 John, the first chapter. And y'all know me and Pastor ain't tall. Pastor ain't know what I'll preach. But I'm going to just read this first verse and then I'm going to jump to the fifth verse because I want to get to you all. In the first chapter, in the first verse, it said, that which was formed from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our own eye, which we have looked upon, which we have handled the word of life. Fifth verse. I think I'm a little excited. It said, this then is the message which we have heard of him and declared unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. And if we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. Oh, Heavenly Father, in Jesus. God, I said right now, God, have your way in this service. Do whatever you desire to do this morning, God, but have free course. God, I anointed my eyes like I do every morning. That you can show me whatever the demonic spirit you desire for me to see. God, I anointed my ears that I hear directly from you. But God, most of all, I anointed my mouth. That I will say nothing of myself, God. But all that you give me to say, God, but right now, we need a word from the Lord. We don't deal what you said. We don't lay the foundation. We don't keep the vision. And the world is mad. But God, we asking for a increase of your anointing. That we can get bolder with your word. That we can speak confidence with your word, God. And God, don't fear the people facing. Don't care what Pensacola said. God, that because you said, if you be lifted up from the earth, God, we come to lift up your name. We come to lift up your word. We come and put a standard in the place, God, that we will keep your saying. And God, we'll forever give you the praise. We'll give you the thing. In your son Jesus' name we pray. And every heart can say, amen, amen, amen. And you can have your seat. I know I'm telling them to put on the seatbelt. But I guess y'all gonna ride without him today. If you get thrown out, you just need to be thrown out. If you ain't living right, and I come down your street because I knew a lot of people get mad with the truth because everybody wanna live right, everybody wanna say they wanna be right, but why we escape the truth? And I found out that Pensacola is so mad with this book. Pensacola is so mad with the word that's coming out of this house. And the slogan said, the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. And I said, so help me God. That's the word today. We're going to continue to speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help us God. It don't matter if they get mad. It don't matter if people don't want to come here. We'll go to heaven all by ourselves. And then we ain't got to worry about it. We ain't got to change God's word like everybody else changing God's word to get people to come to church. Well, we ain't going to change it. We're going to be like the centurion soldier in Matthew 8 and 8. It said the centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof. But speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. We're going to speak the word only that we can be healed in him. It's the word. It's the word. It's the word. People don't want to preach the word, but it's the word. It says speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me God. And truth is way different from false. And so many people are getting false, and they know it's false. They know it's a lie. How are you going to tell me that it's okay for men to be together with a man and a woman to be together with a woman, and y'all tell me y'all endorse that that's okay in the church? No, that is not, that's not right. That's false. How you know, Apostle Simba? Because false means wrong. If God book says wrong, it ain't the truth. And we shouldn't endorse it. He said not genuine. Huh? Not neither truth. Not right. But we're going to speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. And God tell us, there's only one foundation that can be laid, and God already laid it. He told us that in 1 Corinthians 3 and 10 and 11. He said, according to the grace of God, which is given unto me, as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, another build thereon. That's all we can do, is build on the foundation God already laid. He said, but every man take heed how he build thereupon. He said, take heed how you build upon my word. Take heed. And we don't want to take heed. We want to stay. We're going to slide into heaven. God is the, he's the umper. When you slide in, he can say, ow! You live in a kind of way. You can't slide into heaven because you think you don't live good enough. God got a standard. And that's why you got to speak the truth, the whole truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. Ain't nothing else you can get to heaven on. This is what he said. He said in 11 verse, he said, but other foundation can no man lay. That is that laid, which is Christ Jesus. I just wrote me a little bit up under there. Which is the word of God. Because the word became flesh. We handling. You hear what the scripture said right there? He said, which was from the beginning. In the beginning, the word was in the beginning. But 1 John just come on and just explain the thing to us. Because now we don't handle it. We don't see it. And we still want to live some other kind of way. We talking about the church. That's why I said, this might not be for all of us, because all of us don't want the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. We want to snack, crackle, and pop. We want somebody to lie to you and tell you that shacking all right. You want somebody to lie to you and tell you that if you gay, it's all right to be gay. Or you want somebody to tell you that it's all right to do a lit sin. No, if you have an unlawful sex, it's wrong. Put your little panties up, put your little penis up, and it's wrong. Y'all not to be doing it. Trying to have sex unlawful. But they allow y'all to do it in church, and y'all think it's okay. And that's why y'all don't want to come to the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Because the truth makes you see yourself. We trying to bow our way to heaven. Because the preacher riding around in Lamborghini and gator shoes and all that. And then you endorsing him. And he trying to tell you to be blessed by giving him money. He blessed, but you ain't got blessed yet. Because he lying to you. I'd rather for you go to hell with your money. He said, look here in the first verse. He said, the title of that is said, the word of life. And we trying to live by something else. Says, Terry, speak the truth, the whole truth. He ain't said just speak the truth every now and then. Greg ain't know what he was saying that morning. Greg said he ain't got no bean pies to sell. He gonna speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me God. He said he ain't got to sell no bean pie. What he's selling is free. And it's the word. I'm with you, Greg. He said, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard. See, he ain't telling you now. See, he ain't telling your faith come out. He said, your faith come out here. So all of us don't hear it. How can they hear without a preacher? See, you got a crook, you ain't got a preacher. If he ain't living nothing, he can't tell you nothing. And how can anybody still go to church where the joker sits at? You know he a sister. You ain't got to guess he a sister. You know the punk is a sister. And y'all still sit y'all nasty self up in the church where y'all know the preacher crooked at. That's because y'all can endorse him. He in sin. I'm in sin. He can't say nothing. And I can continue to live. But when you come up in here switching. Oh, You bring your little nasty and just wish your little nasty soul him. Bro, I'm going to get you because I'm going to speak the truth. I'm going to tell you, you're on your way to hell anyhow. And you might end up with AIDS in your, what you call them. It might not move nowhere, but where you do it at. What's wrong with the church? Did I say something wrong? Y'all ain't used to the truth. Y'all want me to sugarcoat it? Y'all want to make it feel all right? Some of y'all can get AIDS and having lawful sex, doing it the right way with a man and a woman. Oh, because some of us, you know, we switch out. He said that which was from the beginning. And the church ain't saying nothing. This the same church was shouting and singing before. Oh, here we go. That's why Cornerstone be acting like they be acting when they come to church. Mm-hmm. See, the devil is telling them, I tell them all the time, you think you be getting away, think you be fooling, I tell y'all be fooling your parents, and then you dumb enough, the devil to leave your condom now. Leave your dope. You think you got your dope high, parents some out of the way, fine. My sons, them used to speak prophecy. My friend must have dropped that. Mm-hmm. That which was from the beginning, which we heard. He said, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes. You ain't seen it with nobody else's eye. You seen it with your eye. And you know, so many times people try to say, I'm a find God after a while. He ain't lost. Are you looking for God? He came to seek and save them that lost. He, you can't save nobody. I'm looking for him. I'm looking for him. He gonna find me. But the preacher, we fell in God. Ezekiel 33:3 said, it said, if when he see the sword come upon the land, y'all don't see death everywhere now. And the preacher instead of preaching, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Oh, Lord. They ain't preaching. You got to tell the keyboard to come up where the Holy Ghost at. That's what we like, though. We start jumping. Oh, the preacher. Oh, child, he preach. Well, what did he preach? The choir song, Amazing Grace. What does the preacher preach? Oh. The preacher. You ain't gonna leave him today. He said, if when he see the sword come upon the land, he blows the trumpet and warn the people. Who warning the people now? TVN ain't warning the people. The World Channel ain't warning the people. They telling you to send and get some crosses and some necklace. They telling you to send some money and you look for a blessing. All them people who send all that money, ain't none of them debt free yet. And then they get us to lie on the TV. Everybody that got blessing is all black people. They put on a special show. Y'all ain't seen it. All them cane they throwing out and all that, them people were never crippled. Because if you're that power, you can go on to the hospital. This is what he said. He said, if when you see the sword, I told the Pensacola, I see death coming on the land. And every time you turn around, they were killing each other, young people killing each other. And then we still want to go out there in the world. Well, y'all crazy. He said, but when he see the sword come upon the land, y'all don't see it, the world don't switch out. Everybody think it's okay. I don't care if my son be with another man. I don't care if my daughter be with another man. I don't care if my son smoke dope. And then when they get in trouble, we want God to bail them out. You ain't care why they were doing it. He said, he blows the trumpet and warns the people. Isaiah come back in Isaiah 58:1. He said, cry loud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet. He's talking to us preachers, but he's talking to us people too, because you got kin people that need to be saved. You need to lift up your voice, speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help to God. But you need to live it too. See, that when they find your line. When you save on Sunday, but you smoke dope all through the week and smoke cigarettes. And then you trying to speak prophecy. Let me speak into your life. You need to speak in your own life. You need to go back to that mirror and say, mirror, mirror on the wall, do you see Christ in me at all? You don't need to ask nobody else. You need to ask yourself, how many will see Christ in your life? I ain't talking about that you stop, you know, drinking water. I'm talking about that your life has really changed. That people, you can see that your life changed. See, because if you can't see it, don't expect nobody to see it. He said, cry loud. I'm crying loud. Every chance I get, I'm telling people, y'all going to hell. Because Hosea 4 and 1 said, hear the word of the Lord, you children of Israel. For the Lord has a controversy. He have a problem with his people. He have a problem with us now. Because we only save on Sunday when we come to church. Once we got these doors, we do what we want to do. He said, speak the truth, the whole truth, Paul Summer, nothing but the truth. And I said, so help me God. He said, for I have, the Lord has a controversy with the inheritance of the land, because there is no truth, no mercy, no knowledge of God in the land. We talking about going to church. Ain't nobody changing to be saved now. You think about all the people coming to your job talking about blessed and highly favored. When you really look at their life, what you say? Now they ought to quit. That what you say? And when we say it and we ain't right, we ought to say you ought to quit. We ought to start prophesying to ourselves. If I ain't living right, I ought not to say nothing. Because you're going to trip somebody up. Listen to what it said. He said, lift up that voice like a trumpet and show the people their transgression. Ezekiel and Isaiah had the same assignment. To show their people their transgression. And Malachi said, God has changed it now. Hebrews 13:8 said he the same yesterday and day forevermore. So why the church has stopped telling people they're transgressing and they sin? Why have the church started? He come back and tell them in Ezekiel 33:7, he said, Pastor Simon, this for you, because won't nobody to do it, because they're scared they're going to stop getting their check. What you want me to do, Lord? He said, so thou, O son of man, I have set thee a watchman over Pensacola. He has set me a watchman over Pensacola and surrounding the area, that I will speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Is I got any help in here? Anybody speaking the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? Dog, Cornerstone, y'all kind of slow. Y'all must be in bunk or something. Oh, everybody in Cornerstone ain't speaking the truth. So you ain't living nothing. So you on your way to hell with your little nasty self. Ain't doing nothing for God. Ain't got your mind on God. Got your mind on everything else. You on your way to hell. I ain't said nothing. He said, I have set thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, he said, thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them from me. Warn them. And people think they're going to church. They think they're going to church and going to go to heaven. It's not going to happen. He told Nicodemus, you must be born again. See, this is the truth. What you think born again means? Huh? Nicodemus thought of going back in the mother womb. But wouldn't some of y'all look funny with a pamp on right now? Huh? Wouldn't some of y'all grown up look funny with a pamp? So you ought to know it had to be spiritual. Everybody in church. Oh, I'm saved. God loves me. He loves you. He do love you. He just don't love what you do. But he want to know, do you love him? He said, if you love me, you'll keep my truth. How many of us keeping his truth? Don't put your hand up and lie, because all lies is going to hell. Don't be lifting your hand up and agreeing to something that you ain't with now. Because you know, we used to lie. I don't like that one. I ain't going to hell for y'all to lie. Like I'm right. He said, Apostle Simon warned him for me. He said, but look, he said, there is no truth, no mercy, no knowledge of God in the land. Now, y'all know that bad. We got churches everywhere in Pensacola, and ain't nobody getting saved. All they doing is having a concert. I just heard somebody else, they finna have another concert. So we don't change from going to the club to the church to the club. Huh? Because we got rapping in church, coming to shows in church. We got everything. Because it's going to turn into a business. It ain't no healing place. It ain't no place for people sick, people coming in drunk, changing. In the church and got five children. You had all of them in the church. That's some bad calculation right there. I know God ain't spoke to that preacher at all. Then you're still singing the choir. Just bad. He said, which we have looked upon, and our hand has handled the word of life. Then he come over here in the fifth verse. I love the fifth verse because it made me know that everybody in the church ain't who they supposed to be. Y'all ready to go on this ride with me? And some of y'all ain't where you need to be because they're going to throw you out. That's why I ain't want you to put your seatbelt on. I ain't want to keep you in the car with me. Because God might want to blow the car with you. I want to be able to open the door and let you out. See what I'm saying? Because you don't want to live right. So I don't want to seatbelt you in there with me. Y'all ever seen the movie The Thing? And all them five people sitting there, and one get tested. Say, give me away. Give me away from him. Give me away from him. Because he know the next one might be the thing. That's why I'm going to leave y'all with your seatbelt off. Because y'all might be the thing. How you going to prove that, Apostle? Right here in the fifth verse. 1 John 1 and 5. He said, this then is the message which we have heard of him. Of him. He said, and declared unto you, we have preached this unto you. Yeah. Right, am I right? Declared unto you. He said that God is light. Yeah. And in him. Woo! Now I know them hands ain't going up now. Because I'm going to know y'all liars now. We ain't talking about that light, that little bug show up every now and then, it's just a little light. You know when y'all do something right, and the little bug show a little light. What they call them little bugs? Light bugs. Y'all know they light up every now and then. I don't know how they light. I don't know how God got a light on, but he just that powerful. He wonderful. I'm talking about the little bug be flying around in it. It show a little light and then it disappear. That when y'all do something good. But they say, in God, God is light. And in him, and he put that cross up there, that none of y'all can make no excuse. Because all your little excuses that y'all making, I'm having sex cause I'm still smoking. I ain't paying tithe. I still every now and then. Call division in the church. All y'all going to hell. That's why people don't want to come here. Because it tells you. It tells you that you're wrong. It tells you that you're living right. Because God is light and in him ain't no darkness. And if you say you're in him, you lie. Can't make no excuses. You can't make no excuses. And the preacher make excuses. Because they want you to put $5 in the tank. I don't care if you keep your $5 sticking up in your butt. You still going to hell. God ain't got no time to play with that. All y'all young people know you shouldn't be having unlawful sex, and you're having unlawful sex, you going to hell. And everybody talking about that's too hard. Well, it's hard when we know we got to preach their funeral and we know where they gone. That's hard. That's hard for a mama or dad to know that my son or daughter going to hell and the church fool them. Every little dope man want to put a Bible on his windshield, on the windshield of his car. Or y'all want to put a cloth around y'all neck. And ain't stunned God at all. My dumb self had to put a prayer hand on my hand. And I was the biggest hoe in the bunny club. And I got a prayer hand, prayer changing thing. Well, the show hadn't changed me. You know how y'all got them little tattoos thinking it's going to keep you God, the devil from you. You the devil's servant. Can't keep him from you. He said, this then is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you that God is light and in him is no. Y'all know what no means. It didn't say every now and then. It didn't say could be. And it's the first thing everybody wants to say. You can't judge me. God know my heart. He do know your heart. You got the same filter, sin, and blood that your dad and mama had. Speak the truth, Apostle Simon. The whole truth. Nothing but the truth. I'm the part that said, help me, God. Because I'm a preacher. This is what he said. He said, my people are the scribe for the lack of knowledge because they have rejected knowledge. It ain't that it wasn't no knowledge. They rejected knowledge. And that's the problem with us in here. We come in here and we reject knowledge. We come in here, we ain't going to change. We just come in the church. And someone's coming out of obligation because your mama got handcuffed on you. If your mama tell you you ain't got to come, a lot of y'all young people wouldn't even come. Might as well be real. Because y'all feel like the same way y'all get swindled by people, y'all think y'all can swindle God. Oh, yeah. Y'all ain't got to say nothing. I've been young. Now I'm old. But I yet see. And the seed begging bread. But when you keep serving the devil, you ain't got nobody to serve because the devil going to the lake and you is too. The devil just don't have to stop in hell. He got an express pass. He got a special ticket. Look at how all y'all looking. Look at how all y'all looking. Huh? Y'all on y'all way to hell? I'm talking about in him. We ain't talking about no other church. Y'all on y'all way to hell in him. We ain't talking about outside the church. Y'all on y'all way to hell in him. God told you last week, go to hell. And y'all still went back out the horn after other stuff. God would have told me to go to hell. I would have did some paperwork. I said, God, any way we can cancel that one? Huh? Yeah, y'all ain't got to say nothing. He said, declare unto you that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie. How many of us got fellowship with God? I'm going to help y'all lie. Oh, the hand to God. Y'all put them down, because y'all try to act like y'all didn't hear what I said. Ain't none of y'all getting in slow and special. All y'all can hear. Well, I had that question on hand time. Y'all know that little man on 300 couldn't go. He couldn't go because he couldn't get here. Y'all shield went gold. Y'all one went gold. I see y'all. Y'all know y'all on y'all way to hell, and truth gonna get you there. Truth gonna get you there. I don't know why people try to find a church. They ain't gonna tell them the truth. I want to change. I don't need nobody playing with me. I'm serious. And some of y'all don't be there so long. Mr. Clean should be done clean y'all. But the word can't even clean y'all. God can't clean y'all. I know y'all can't be clean. It ain't that you can't be, you don't want to be. Some of us like what we do. He said, if we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, y'all tell me no other preacher ain't got this in their book. Huh? Y'all tell me that. Y'all. So all y'all that said, what a wonder. All y'all just sung that and still in darkness. I couldn't wait to get out here. I feel pretty good in my sanctified soul. Because I'm light. And in me ain't no darkness at all. Huh? Anyway, he said, Pastor, you can't say that. You do something wrong. But in light, you know what repentance is. And then you just, See, y'all try to wait to get the church to repent. Y'all, you should have been repent when you were doing what you were doing. We got more members than that. What's the rest of y'all got some hooks in y'all butt. It won't let y'all sit up. Some of y'all got some hooks in y'all butt. It won't let y'all move. Oh, they ain't put them on when I told them to put them on before. He said, if we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. Ain't that you ain't doing nothing. Cornerstone, y'all something else. Y'all gonna continue in sin that grace abounds. Y'all gonna continue in sin. I see y'all. I see y'all, Cornerstone. I see y'all. I see y'all. Ain't a lot of y'all ain't planning on changing. That's why God sent this message. He paused. I'm gonna show you something. I see it now. A lot of y'all don't have a plan to change. Y'all gonna take it all the way to the door. Y'all gonna try God. Y'all gonna try him. I see y'all. I see y'all. I see y'all. I'm telling you, I see him. L, I see him. He said, but if we walk in the light, as he is the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from. But if we say that we have no sin, we deceive our own self. And the truth, I'm going to leave that alone. I'm going to move on here because my spirit is seeing me somewhere. Because this is why I know what God is showing me. This is our problem. And I just got this scripture when I was in the bag. Galatians. Now I see why God took me here. I see it now. I see it now. God, I see you. I hear you. I hear you. I hear you. I know y'all on him. So, you know, y'all used to preach to give y'all one scripture and tag it. He told me to speak the truth. So everything I'm giving you is the truth, the word. I ain't switching out on you. Galatians 1 and 4. He said, who gave himself for our sin? Huh? That he might deliver us from this present evil world. He did it that he might deliver us, and we still love the world. You know, I preach a message. Don't love the present world and the things in it. Lust of the eye, lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. They are not of God. They are of the world. And y'all still there. God just gave me this scripture. Now I see why he took me there. If it would have been around the lab, but he don't took me here now. He said, for our sin, that he might deliver us from this present evil world, according to the will of God and our Father, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into grace of Christ unto another gospel. I wonder why God put me there, but I follow him. Y'all got another gospel. Y'all don't want the truth, the whole truth, nothing but truth. And he just gave me this. And now he told me to go him because you see why? Listen what he said. He's telling me what I just told you. Some of y'all ain't going to do what he said. It don't matter how much the whole truth, nothing but the truth serves God. Look what it said. I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into grace of Christ unto another God, which is not another. He said, let all these preachers fool you. Let your friends fool you. Let everybody fool you. There is no other gospel. When I say heaven and hell, that's what I mean. There is no purgatory. There's no in between. You going one to the other. And most of y'all I see don't chose to go to hell. Oh, I ain't through. He said, which is not another. But there be some that trouble you. Huh? And will prevent the gospel of Christ. Pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we are in an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel, unto you. Huh? Than that which you have preached unto you, let him be accursed. All these preachers that preach in another gospel, God said, let them be accursed. And if you change in God's word, he said, your name will be blotted out the book. He said, Apostle Simon, speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me God. He said, if they preach in the other gospel, he said, let him be accursed. As we said before, so say now again. If any man preach any other gospel unto you, then that you have received, let him be accursed. For do I now persuade man or God? Huh? Or do I seek to please man? For if I yet please man, I should not be. Man, that's rough right there. I don't know. 1 Corinthians 1 and 10. 1 Corinthians 1 and 9. He said, God is faithful, by whom you were called unto the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Now I beseech you, now I entreat you, I beg you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you all speak the same thing, and that be no division among you, but that you be perfectly joined together in the same mind and the same judgment. Apostle, you don't understand, but let's come on over here. Romans 1 and 16. For I am not ashamed. Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation, unto everyone that believes. Most of y'all don't believe. I see y'all for real though. A lot of y'all just coming. Y'all have no plan on living for God. And for that call, he got a place for you. Yeah. Y'all know his word, and he said, he that knows to do right, he gonna beat you with many scribes. And y'all choosing to take it all the way to the door. Y'all ain't trying to change. That's why God told me, speak the truth, the whole truth, and keep preaching it. Because you're going to send a bunch of these people straight out here to hell. Everybody listen to Broadcast 91, everybody going to YouTube, they going straight to hell. Because you're doing what I told you to do. And we think we got time. We do. He said, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation for to everyone that believes. To the Jew first, and also the Greek. But therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. Yeah. To the just. I preached a message for this one time. God, let me do what I want to do. It's my will. I preached that a long time ago, but I see some of us still got our own will. Y'all don't believe hell real. So that means you don't believe hell real, you don't believe heaven. If you don't believe hell and heaven real, you don't believe God. Because all of it's in the book. This is what he said in 18th verse. He said, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodly. He ain't said some ungodly. He said all ungodly and unrighteous of men who hold the truth. He said, who hold the truth? He's telling you right there. That's what he said. He said, so they are without excuse. The 21st verse. It said, because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God. As they knew the truth, they still glorified God not as God. Ain't nobody doing that in hell, though, is. Huh? Because we know God, there ain't no darkness in God. So ain't nobody glorifying and stuff they doing that ain't godless. I'm talking about like your attitudes and, you know, because we'll sneak away that we don't go to the club no more. Some of us ain't having sex no more. Some of us too old to have sex. So we might not be having sex. Our molecules don't got slow. So you might be exempt from that. But there's a lot more in that book that don't exempt you. Y'all ain't got to say nothing. You know, y'all just gonna tell me, well, I don't have sex no more. Child, I don't go to the club no more, but you still cuss.
My God.
I don't cuss no more. You still nasty. All that ain't God. That all that done. Not speaking. And know you see me. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither was thankful. You know, like you always complaining? God always blessing them. It ain't blessing me. And a person might have counsel. And you ain't got counsel. You just ain't got the money. But you ain't thankful that God got you. Yeah. I don't care. Them jokers gonna be rich and have all kind of money. God, I'm all right. Just keep me. You understand? Don't put none of that stuff on me and make me start, you know, not giving, not being thankful. He said, but became vain in their imagination, and their foolish heart was dark, professing themselves to be wise. No, there ain't none of y'all. James said in James 1 and 5, he said, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that give all man. See, he ain't even respect him. He give all me. See what I'm talking about? Here's a God that give everybody. That's why I said, they quick to say, a God love the just and the unjust. Yeah, he dropped rain on all of them. He do. He give all us job, and he also do the separation. Y'all can put them night clothes on and come to church, it ain't changing. Let me just talk to y'all young people. Y'all know sex don't last that long. Because half of y'all don't know what y'all doing anyway. Y'all can look up here. That cat kissing and mooching and all that, it don't last that long. Y'all can look up here. Have y'all don't brush your teeth all the time and all that, so you know y'all probably even need to be kissing anyway. And you don't know how to clean your tail. Y'all doing something, y'all stepping off in a zone you don't want. And then sooner you get a baby, you tell me you don't know how it happened. Well, let me tell you how it happened. You lay it down over your legs up. Baby don't happen out the sky. Lord. And I know the Holy Ghost ain't getting y'all pregnant. Because Holy Ghost don't go in there unfiltered. Y'all ain't got to say nothing. In Proverbs 1 and 7, it said, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. A lot of us don't fear him. He said, but a fool despises wisdom and instruction. It takes a fool to sit up here and despise what God's saying in his truth. Amen. He's telling us that I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and y'all trying to go another way. I'm serious. How do you do that? I don't been down that road where I think I got all the sin. But most of y'all still think y'all got all the sin, even though y'all don't heard God's word. When I was in the world, I ain't know nothing about God. Ain't nobody been telling me nothing. I thought everything I was doing was all right because everybody around me was doing it. So wasn't nobody talking about God around me. But y'all don't heard the truth. And still say, man, I ain't still what the pastor saying. Pastor ain't running nothing. He ain't my dad. He ain't my mom. Sure like. Sure like. He said, because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God. Neither were thankful, but became vain in their imagination, and their foolish heart was darker, professing themselves to be wise. They became fools. Y'all hear that? They became. No, man, y'all, Pastor, you don't understand. And I know the preacher fooled y'all with Psalm 23 and 6. Surely. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord. Which one of them? Because he made both of them. You're going to dwell somewhere for a permanent. I hope some of y'all appetite be messing when y'all go over there and eat. I hope the food spoil in your stomach. I do. I hope God, for everything you eat, I hope it tastes nasty to you. I hope you get sick off it. Y'all rejecting God's word like that, sitting up here all leaning in the seat, all like y'all in a club or something. God trying to speak to y'all that nasty self, and y'all ain't trying to heal. But as soon as you get something that you ain't got no business having, then you want to call on an apostle. You want to burn somebody a number because you want help then. But long as you walking strong, as long as you good, you don't need that. Let me talk to the real believer. Amen. The whole truth. Nothing but the truth. In St. John 15 and 3, he said, now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. So that means you can't get clean unless somebody speak the whole truth to you. Ephesians 5 and 26 said that he might sanctify it and clean it with the washing of the water by the word. In other words, the church need a bath. He tells you in St. John 17:17, he says, sanctify them through thy truth, thy word is truth. You can't get clean unless you get the word. Everybody trying to tell y'all about laying hands on you, and let me lay hands on you, let me transfer my spirit, let me wipe my sweat on you. Them lies. Them lies. God did some of that stuff in that time period, but now he ain't doing that because Jesus died. That's the ultimate thing you need is him, that word. Huh? I'm serious. We going after everything else. I wouldn't care if I ain't have a job, make a lot of money. Because God can stretch that what I got if I do the right thing with it. That's what I'm wrong with y'all. I worked on the bay for 31 years. And everybody thought I was making good money. I had sins. I had sins when I was in the world. Not to waste my money on things that wasn't no good. And all the girls trying to like me and stuff like that. I wasn't taking y'all to no restaurant. No. I ain't taking y'all to no hamburger stand, no nothing. Ain't nothing going on. I'ma just fool you. Because y'all like to be fooled. And what the church like? The church like that. They like to be fooled. If I was fooling y'all in here, the church would be all the way back to the back. Y'all would be telling people about the church. But see, y'all don't want people to know you're supposed to be living like that too. So if you tell them and bring them here and they hear what you're saying, they're going to say, well, what's wrong with you? That's why we don't bring no visitor. Why y'all think there ain't no visitor here? You tell me we can't get one visitor from all these people here? No, y'all don't want to bring them here because y'all know the truth being told. And if they size your life up with the truth, they're going to say, oh, you in error. So we ain't quick to bring nobody here. Now, none of y'all want to look up here now. That's why they ain't come here. They ain't trying to get nobody to come here. Because if I brought some of my old friend here and I was still doing some stuff, they said, man, what you go there for? But let me tell you what Amos said as I close. Amos 8. And 11. He said, Apostle Simba, speak the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me God. He said, give instruction to a wise man, and he will be yet wise. Teach a just man, and he will increase in learning. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. But Amos said, God, I've been preaching to these people. I've been talking to these people. Jeremiah said, I don't even want to talk to them no more. Isaiah said, I've been crying loud, spare now, I've been doing all you said. They still don't want to do it. Jeremiah come back and said, God, these people don't want to obey you. Amos come and said, behold. Said, look, all y'all in here that ignoring God. Y'all just picture me as Amos talking to you all. All y'all that's going against God's word, all y'all that's contrary, all y'all think y'all got it going on. This is for you. He said, behold, the day coming. Said the Lord. Y'all just act like this today. I've been speaking the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. I've been living right, we've been living right, we've been teaching y'all all things. But Amos said, behold, the day coming, said the Lord, not Amos, the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, no, a thirst for water. I'm going to let y'all keep getting fat. And I'm going to let you keep your mouth being wet. I'm going to let y'all still do what y'all do. I'm going to let y'all eat well. I'm going to let y'all still party. I'm going to let y'all do it all you want. You know, because y'all going to eat, drink, and be merry. I'm going to let y'all do all that. But he said, behold, the day coming. It's a day going to come when y'all going to want the word. You might be on your back. You might not be able to comprehend what being said. But you're going to want the word. And I don't start answering, I'm not answering some phone call. Call who you were calling before. I don't need to go to that scripture, dude. God told him, I'm not getting y'all out of that no more. When you get into tribulation, call them who you've been hanging with. Call them who you want to go and see. Call them the rapper. Call them that dope man. Call that girl you were knocking off. Call them when you get into tribulation. Call them. Then what he said right here, this is another part of what Amos said. He said, there will be a famine. But not when you stop eating. Not when you stop drinking. He said, but a hearing the word of the Lord. And I'm wondering, some of y'all got a reprobated mind. That you sit up here and hear God's word, but you got a still ear to it that can't then change you. I don't care what they say. I don't care how they say it. I don't want to hear that. There were more people when they leave this church, they leave that because of that. They don't leave it because of nothing else. Because you tell me why everybody tell me, oh man, the church, I'm going to leave the church because they got, every time you turn around, some kind of problem. Well, why you don't leave your job? I had all kind of problems with my job for 31 years. I retired there. I went through 31 years, a number of trouble with people, and I ain't quit yet. And they weren't paying that kind of, that much money. But I needed my job. But y'all have quit church. And y'all don't quit cause of people. Y'all don't quit cause of people. When people leave him, they leave him because of this. Let me show it to y'all because y'all don't know what it is. They leave because of this book right here. Because it got it on the wall. The truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me God. When we keep preaching truth, you know one thing. You're going to never be able to shake. Now, you might shack and come in here, but you know it might come up. You ain't going to be able to smoke and stay up in here. Because we're going to talk about the temple. You defile the temple. You can't be drinking. Huh? You can't be cussing. Because he said sweet and bitter water don't come out of the same fountain. And you can't be around filthy communication because it corrupts good manners. We're talking about the book. We're talking about the truth. The whole truth, nothing but the truth. Huh? We ain't talking about trying to get you to get no $5 extra offer. We talking about $5 extra percent living right. Every time you come in here, you ought to get another percentage that says, this is how I ought to live. And God shouldn't have to tell us that. But he said, but of hearing the word of the Lord, and they shall wander from sea to sea. You're going to be running around looking for a word. From north even to the east, they shall run to and fro seeking a word of the Lord and shall not find it. Now ain't that something? You're going to be running all over the church. Oh, you got some notes. Help me, Jim. Help me, Jamil. Trying to, you gotta worry about it. Oh, she crazy. She's scared too. No, sir. I can't find her. Know what you gonna be? Just like them crack people. They be looking in the dirt for crack. They be looking. I said, what they digging for? They looking for crack. What about? They maybe somebody drop some. That's how your mind gonna be. You're gonna be looking for a word, and he said, you shall not find it. I'm waiting before I get saved. I'm waiting before I get my life right. It's gonna come a time, you're gonna wish you had a word, and God said, Terry, they shall not find it. And y'all trying to wait to get right. I don't understand that. Jesus on this road came out to 42 generations, died for you and said, Father, it is finished. Sin have no dominion over your people. He don't go on to prepare the place for us. But we want to choose door number two, which is hell. Someone in the church. Me ain't going to keep me out of heaven. Me will keep you out from being close to God. Why y'all think some of y'all rebelled against your parents and stuff like that? Why you think y'all rebelled? If you rebel your parents, you don't know God. All these things y'all done did, man, all of them did that. Y'all like y'all doing something new. The book said there's nothing new under the sun. Archie was back there then. Choking his chicken was back there then. That's a bad sin to choke your chicken. However, you're going to get you one. Get you a woman. We playing, y'all. God sent a 2 minutes word in here. And we take it for granted. He said in 2 Timothy 3 and 16, he said, all scripture is given by the inspiration of God and is possible for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the men of God may be perfectly thoroughly furnished unto all good work. He's an apostle symbol. What they gonna do with the Bible? Because ain't nobody trying to stay with the Bible. What they gonna do with that book? They talking about the biblical information for leaving earth. Well, why they ain't preaching out of it? And everybody mad with us because we standing on the truth. I tell you, pastor said it, but we the best thing going in Pensacola. We the best thing, not. Might be the best thing. We the best thing going to Pensacola. And until we realize that, I ain't talking to y'all no dead joker don't want to stand up because I said we the best thing. Maybe you're not a part of it. But I'm talking to the one that know we the best thing that happened. I ain't talking to your deadbeat joker. You had to almost put a jack up on their butt to get them to smooth. Like you ain't a part. But you're going to go there and eat that food like you're a part. That folks be eating on ground like family and friend. Yeah. If you ain't in family, you ain't friend. Get in your car and go home like you a visitor.
Say that.
Stop gathering with us on the thing we do as a church. Take your little nasty self on home. He said, tell Apostle Simon you got to preach the word, the whole word. What you mean, God? He said, I charge thee. I'm charging the leadership today. And I'm charging all of us that said we all in. I ain't charging everybody. So this don't apply to some of y'all that live in darkness. Because we can't use y'all. He said, I charge you therefore before God and the Lord Jesus, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearance and his kingdom. Caleb, Jameel, Noah, all y'all, Jeremiah, Cameron, all y'all, Caleb, all y'all, preach the word. Amen. I'm talking to every young kid in here, preach the word. I got to talk to y'all because the rest of these young ones don't got away and some of the old ones got, but I'm creating a generation. Preach the word. Be us in this season. Out of season, reprove, rebuke, exalt with all long suffering. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. But after their own lust, till they take heed to themselves, teachers, having itch ears, they want to tell me something good. Tell me something like it. Yeah. Tell me. You just want something. Y'all young men, preach the word. Dinner, preach the word. Preach the word. Preach the word, Noah, Caden, Joshua. Preach the word. I'm talking to y'all young kids. Eileen, Jalen, preach the word. Preach the word, man. I'm talking to you young kids because y'all old people, y'all don't want to say nothing to nobody about God because y'all don't want to offend nobody. I got to go down to the next generation. Raylan, preach the word, baby. Talking to you young people. Y'all older guys, y'all young people, y'all don't want to offend nobody. All y'all been in Cornerstone for a long while, y'all don't want to offend y'all co-workers. Y'all don't want to tell nobody the truth, the whole truth. Y'all just tell them to list something. But y'all don't want them to fall out with y'all. He said, but the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own love, God, I love you. I love you for real, God. Because you good, God. He good, y'all. He said, this then is the message which we have heard of him and declared unto you, that God is light, and in him is no doctrine at all. If we say we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. Lord, help us. I'm saved, oh Lord, for real, by the word. Ain't nobody got to lay hands on me. I'm saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, and I ain't just saying it. And I walk by faith, not by sight. And I ain't just learned that. I knew that when I was just getting in the church. He just said, faith is the substance of things, hope for the evidence of things not seen. The just shall live by. And you apostles just found that out. You better turn your credentials in. He told me to speak the truth, the whole truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. I like the satirical. So do what you got to tell God. God, I'm not even worthy for you to come to my house. But speak the truth on it. And my servant already healed. Lord, have mercy. Oh, God. And hereby, we do know that we know him if we keep his commandment. He that said, I know him and keep not his commandment is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoso keepeth his word in him verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby, we are in him, and he that says he abide in him ought to himself also to walk even as what you say. Lord, thank you. Y'all ain't seen Jesus walk, because I know that them little pictures on the TV, they don't do him justice. Amen. I know it. They don't do him justice. They don't know how you walk. How you walk, Pastor?
All right, man. Thank you.
Come on, way up there, Father. He walked with authority. Head up, never looking down at the ground. He never feared what was before him, around him. He knew who his daddy was. He ain't had to worry about no soldier, nothing. That's why he talk about, man, you live by that sword, you'll die by it. Boy, I got power to call just one angel, just one leader to mess these jokes up, but I came to die. Any of y'all come to die? Die for your family? That your family can see God in you? Jesus came to die for us. Huh? He said, Father, if it's possible, let this cup pass. Prayed it 3 times. But he came to himself. He said, but nevertheless, this is what I came to do. And now he told us to occupy. So that means some of us got to die to ourselves. Amen. He said, let a seed go in the ground and die and abide alone. It can't bring forth no fruit. When I hear somebody now, that's all I want to tell them. Speak the word. Don't tell me what you think. Don't tell them what you feel. Speak the word on them. All this prophets and stuff, all this, I can be rich in 3 days. Now deal with my life, because I'm messed up. Because I know that I heard in the word, and St. John 15:3, it said, now you are clean through the word which I have spoken to you. I need the word. Yeah. Ephesians 5:26 said that he might sanctify and clean it with the washing of the word. I need the word. And he told me in 2 John 17:17, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is true. My sanctification has come from what been preached out of me. He said, should we continue in sin that grace abound? They said, God forbid. All y'all think y'all is licensed to still sin? God forbid. I can't wait till I get to walk in heaven. I don't want to see mama. I don't want to see daddy. Peter, John, Luke. I don't want to see none of them. I want to see that man that said, Father, it is finished. That's who I want to see. Everybody else can fall in line later on. But show me him. I want to see it with my own eye. They give me a crown. I might be going to get thrown out of line. I might be going to throw mine down too early. But I might still have some of that symbols in me. I might be. But I'm here now. You can't put me out of there. I ain't going out now, God. You had to fight now. Nah, boy, I'm going to lock on to somebody up there. I ain't getting out of there. But some of us ain't going. Ain't none. A lot of us ain't sure we going. But I make preparation. But you making preparation to go one way or the other. Yeah, and that's why I'm telling y'all. I'm telling y'all. Me, if the Cornerstone shut down, I'm not going to no church that's lying to me. I bet you that one. Before me and Katrina go to church, somebody they're going to lie to us, girl, get you a mess. I sit down, you preach one to me, I preach one to you. We ain't going nowhere they play. Keep our own tithing off it. Get us a little bucket. You need the word to be sanctified. Tell me how big your church is. Child, what good your church being big when you going to a little place where ain't number five burning? He good, y'all. Serious, we thank God for him. I see we got a visitor back in the back. You don't have to say nothing, but if you want to, you can.